me. Girl, don't you see? There ain't nobody gonna take from me. Daddy said to live your life, rolling her down on your rights. You got to give all your heart if you want to.
Jay Shrek! Well, where in the hell are we at today? Well, we're doing what we do best. And I don't even know what the hell that really is. But what we're doing today is we are walking down roads aimlessly looking for lost civilizations. And, you know, you get leads and you look at Google Earth and you spend a lot of time out in the field walking. You know, looking for places that you believe exist, but you're really not sure that they're out here or not. But there's a lot of worse things you could be doing right now, right? So we're gonna get it on today and try to figure out what's out here. You know, we're in the middle of a field. I say a field, it's really not a field. It's pretty much just empty land. But you ever get that weird feeling that there's something out there and that you just got to go look? And you know, the only thing you can do is come out here and take a look. And you know, 50-50, 50% of the time you probably don't find anything, but that other 50%, I'm telling you what, and maybe not even 50, maybe it's 20, but it makes it all worthwhile. So we're gonna come out today. Another double secret. Now, this is a double secret location that I won't tell anybody about. If I happen to find something out here, you know, which again is probably rare, but this is gonna stay secret. So we're gonna take a look and just see what's out here today. And man, if we get lucky, then guess what? It's gonna be awesome. So that's what we're looking at right there. It's the big old open field. So you never know where this stuff's at. So you just gotta go. You gotta do the work. Take a walk. Load up the water. And get your hiking shoes on. And just still another beautiful day, overcast. You don't get a lot of overcast days in Arizona, but we definitely got one today. Got a lot of area to walk in today. One thing about Arizona is you definitely got a lot of area to walk in, but you know, if we get lucky today, we might just find a couple things. So we'll just see how that works out. But we'll be on the journey, and I'll when I get a little closer, we'll get you back on. So make sure that you tighten up your shoes, tighten up those laces, put a double knot in them, and let's get to hiking. You with me? Let's go today. Should be an interesting day today, though. Can't wait. So a lot of people ask, you know, how do you know? You know, so what am I looking for when I'm out here, you know, just walking through here? I'm looking for swells. I'm looking for walls, definitely walls, but you know, a lot of times that you're not gonna find walls. But you're looking for indentations. You know, everything out here could possibly mean something, and you gotta take a look to see if maybe it does. So what you're doing is you're looking through here. Another thing I look at is I look at clumps of vegetation in a field that maybe there shouldn't be any, or you wouldn't think there would be any. And so when I look at that stuff, I'm kind of like, so was there water? Now, I'm gonna show you something right now that we just stumbled into that is almost heart-stopping. Man, I am not even believing this. We've got shards, and we've got massive amounts of shards. Look at this. Right here. Man, I'm telling you what, I'm shocked. Okay, look right here. Look at there. This is, I just stumbled into something. Now the ground's been disrupted, so I don't know exactly what that means, unless there possibly could be a wall. There could be something in that area like that. I'm seeing massive shards, and I'm seeing massively large shards. And I found color. So that's a big deal. And they are everywhere. This is absolutely incredible. I am seeing stuff everywhere. How incredible is this site? This site's so pristine, I don't even want to hardly pick anything up. You know, I can see how this ground was disrupted. And, wow. This was a big site. This is an incredible site. I'm kind of in shell shock. I didn't expect to find anything like this at all. I am, don't even know how to act right now. I'm pretty stoked, but I'm also, man, look at this. These shards are everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. Look at this piece right here. Wow, look at this stuff. That's a coyote. So a coyote has found the digging well here. Let's walk around here a little. With the amount of shards that we found a major location. This is a major location. Now this is a pit right here. This was dug. I can tell that this was dug. Look at that. Look at that. Oh my gosh, look at this thing. This is absolutely incredible. This has definitely been dug. How fascinating is this? Look at this. Look at that. Wow. This is overwhelming. I'm telling you what, this is a pretty incredible sight we've just stumbled across. This is kind of crazy. Man, this mound is unbelievable here. Look at this stuff. There's pieces all the way through here. Now I'm seeing another area that has a lot of foliage that has drawn me over there, because again I'm looking for things out here that are different. So look at this entire area. There is shards everywhere throughout here. Wow, look at that. Wow. That is a big piece right there. Man. I'll tell you what, I'm stoked. This is absolutely incredible. Wow. So we're gonna wander around out here a little more. Because of the amount of shards that we found, got a lot of disruption in the ground, which would mean that probably there were walls There are probably walls out here. There would have been some type of burial location also out here. Definitely. So the amount of ground that is disrupted. Now, one thing when I look at Google Earth, I look at, you can tell where there's areas when you start to get to look at them, even if you don't see walls. You can tell that the ground has been disrupted. And usually that means there's something there. Now, if a culture had been out here for years, then, you know, they're going to disrupt this ground, and you can see that on Google Earth. You can see how they have worn the areas if they were in here, which is pretty incredible. Now, this little area over here looks like I've run out of shards through here. No, there's some here. So it's kind of running through here. Now, the regular ground looks fairly, I mean, somewhat flat, but the areas that's really disrupted, you can definitely tell that something's going on. So we're going to walk over here to this area right here because it has a, would have meant there's water. There's water here now. So that means that it's getting water, and that's why there's growth here. So that could have been one of the reasons that they're here. So we'll go in here and take a look and see if we see any more remnants of yeah, this doesn't look like something that was just natural. Now here's some old cans here. So somebody's been out here, you know, years ago. I don't think any of this is new or fresh. But so there have been people here. Now what they've been doing, I don't know, but this looks like a little, either a dugout area or a pond of some type. Maybe there was some type of spring. Now here's another mound that is not looking natural, looking like somebody's been out here doing something. I'm seeing a few shards, not a lot, but I'm seeing a few shards through here. You know, I don't know if in one day there was a stream that ran through here, but there's a lot of remnants through here, but this looks disrupted. You can tell this landscape is disruptive. It's disrupted. Wow. I tell you what, I'm. You never know when you come out here. Looks like that somebody had been digging this at one time. And, you know, before 1960, people did this. You know, and it wasn't totally illegal to do this, which is, when you think about how crazy that is, that's insane that they would allow people to dig legally in these locations like this. You know, people are like, don't tell anybody. Well, up till 1960, hell, they dug whatever they wanted to dig. So it's sad, but it is true. I don't know what that is. That looks like some type of a worm or a snake. This does not look natural to here, though. This looks definitely dug. Another area right there that definitely has drawn me over here. Another area where I've got vegetation, which makes me think that there possibly could be something over here. So far we've hit on each one of them. So let's take a look and see if there's anything over here. We're seeing shards all the way through here. So this was a big area. This was a fairly big civilization through here. But this is not something that the average person is going to stumble on if you haven't done your work. Yeah, there's shards all over here. Look at this. And there's dug holes right there. This definitely looks dug right here. Oh, look at there. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Wow. Look at that piece right there. Beautiful. That's beautiful. I've seen a few painted pieces Oh my gosh, we got shards everywhere. This was a big, big dig right here. Look at that. Tell you what, if you can't tell, I'm pretty excited because I mean we're seeing dig areas all the way through here. We're looking through here. You know, somebody has dug this more than one time. You can tell just by the way it lays out. And you can find these areas here too. I'll tell you what, I'm pretty stoked. I mean, here's another disruptive area right here that doesn't look like your normal. Like somebody dug this. Some nice pieces all the way through here. It's an incredible location. This is an incredible location. There's a lot of old cans out here, which means that people have been out here for a long time. Right there, right there. Now this looks like actually a waterway or a creek, but this looks dug also, right through here. We're gonna work our way back through the other way. I'll tell you, man, again, you just don't know what you're gonna find. When you come out here, I'm seeing a lot of trash, which means that people have been out here and they've been in this area. This just didn't blow in here. You know, more cans like that. And that's old stuff right there. So they've had thieves digging out here. But probably the best shards I've seen. I mean, they're right up there. Maybe whole lobby. Something like that. That's got a spectacular amount for especially the amount of people that go there. Wow. More cans. Old, look like old Bud can or beer cans. So we've had pretty good luck actually by going to the places that definitely looks disrupted out here. And man, here's back over here where this kind of well. Now there's some other stuff, trees over there. I'm definitely going to check out. I'm going to try to walk this whole perimeter. Once you find a location, then you know that, okay, this is all flat ground too. You know, no, they could have had buildings. I don't see any, you know, there could be a few mesquite trees, but I don't see a lot of trees that they would have built permanent structures. Now, I don't see any walls, but if there are walls on a flat ground, you know, they've been covered. So they could be here and we're walking over them. We can't even see them. So we're going to walk back in through here. There's some intriguing areas down here that I'm going to study a little deeper. All this has been dug. All this, you can tell. There might be some really nice pristine walls underneath this ground. The soil is really loose, so this would have been extremely good farming. So that's what I'm going to tell you that I believe they were doing here, was this was farming. Wow. Man, how incredible. I mean, you just don't know what you're going to find when you come do this. I don't know if there's any more stuff out here or not, but there's places I'm definitely going to check out because I'm seeing stuff out here that definitely, I mean, every time I turn around and look, here's a nice piece right there, and I'm out here kind of in the middle of nowhere in this area, but all this land looks really disrupted. So we're going to keep wandering around. Kind of funny flat stone sitting out here on its own. Oh, that's interesting. So is that rock right there. That's pretty interesting. This was a massive dig. Look at these. Again, here we are, 60s. You know, when they could dig this legally. It's kind of funny we allowed. How did we allow that to happen? Boy, we weren't on the gas in the 60s, definitely. Look at all this stuff. We got stuff everywhere. We got burial grounds. We've got ball fields. I can tell. We got everything. This was a big society out here. Here's another area over here. I mean, we're stumbling into all this stuff. How incredible is this? It's interesting. This shows the possibility that there were larger mesquite trees out here at one time. But I mean, the remnants of trash out here, beer cans, just is proof to me that we have hit a location that, you know, has been ravaged. Look at this. The coyote holes are deep. The coyotes like it out here, maybe because it's sacred to them as well. There's coyote dens all over. I haven't seen that many coyote dens. They're everywhere. Look at that. We got Coyote City out here. So that's what I'm going to call this, is Coyote Ruins. Probably has a real name, and that's okay, because I don't, you know, this one we ain't letting out. So I'm going to call this Coyote Ruins. Why? Because there's coyotes all over this. There's a huge amount of families in here. Not sure on that piece right there. Screen rock doesn't look. But if you look through here, I mean, all the way through here, all this, there's stuff everywhere. And one of the things that's regrettable as we're walking through here is the amount of aluminum cans and crap. God only knows what's down here in these coyote holes. Wood, something made of wood here. There's something right here. Maybe a little sign of some type. Like I said, I don't know how far to, you just keep wandering and it doesn't run out. There's a bone of some type right there. Now, you are going to find bones out in these locations. I mean, it's just what it is. Leave them alone, but you're going to find them. So don't think you're not going to find them. And I'm not saying that was human. I'm not saying it is or it isn't. But I am saying that you will find them if you keep doing this. And like I said, I'm hitting shards all over this area. This is definitely all dug. I'm seeing shards everywhere, all over this. This looks dug. It's kind of a nice combination of the colors of the pots right there. Isn't that pretty? That's beautiful. You know, I was heading to the truck and I saw this can here. It's a Budweiser can with a pull top. Got the seal right there. Look at that. So, there we go. That's got some color right there. Pretty color. Got a little red on it. You know, I've said this before, but shards are important because they can tell you, you know, the style, which is going to tell you the year, you know, the amount of debris that you find. It's going to be able to tell you, you know, how big the community was, how long they probably existed. There's all kinds of different stuff of, you know, how advanced they were in their culture. So it really is important that you leave them where they're at. And I can kind of tell that this place, even though it got picked through, people have this weird tendency to stack shards in locations and spots, you know, on rocks, and don't do that. That's pretty interesting right there. Well, we're going to head back to the truck. I think we're going to call today a day. And man, hope you enjoyed it. If you like what we do, please like our channel. Please subscribe to our channel. And when you hit notification, please hit all. That way, everything that we put out, you know, you'll get an email basically. They'll say, hey, we've got a new show coming out. So if you like this, you'll be the first to know. And We appreciate all the support. Thanks again for taking care of us, and have a safe trip. Be careful when you're out there, but get out there. Jay Shrek, Black Flag Expeditions. Another cool coyote ruins today. Today kicked ass, and you know it did. This isn't stuff that people see. This is the double secret stuff right here. And if you want to see more double secret stuff, only one place you're going to see it, and that's right here. Want to thank Todd Beck again for all the support. Want to thank John and Maria McGrath for supporting us, taking care of us. And for everybody else out there, you know, we appreciate all the support we get. Take care. Have a great day. Bam.